This tutorial will demonstrate how a number of different foundation types may be quickly added to a SAP 2000 model using parametrically driven assemblies. We will show how to define the foundations and then add the foundation assemblies to a model. Five different types of foundations may be modeled, including isolated footings, combined footings, pile groups, pile piers, and pile shafts. We will use a model created using the 2D frame template. The model consists of a single bay 2 stories tall. The foundations will be added at the base of the columns. To create the foundations, we start by going to the Define menu and clicking on the Foundation Properties command. Since no foundations have previously been defined, we will click on the Add New Foundations button. Again, we have the five options: isolated footing, combined footing, pile group, pile pier, and pile shaft. For this tutorial, we will focus on the isolated footing foundation, otherwise known as a spread footing, but the defining of the parametric variables and the drawing of the foundations on the model follows a similar approach for all of the foundation types. At the top of the form, we have a diagram that identifies each of the parametric variables. The area below is where we can enter the values for these variables. Starting with the name for this footing, we will modify it by adding 1. Next is the concrete material for the footing, where we can select from previously defined materials, in this case 4000 psi. Next is the total length. We want a 6-foot square footing, so we will enter a value of 72 inches. We will enter the same value for the total width. We will set the thickness to 24 inches. And the maximum mesh size controls how finely the footing should be meshed in the finite element model. We will change this to 24 inches. The last data section is for the soil properties. The first item is the soil cover, the amount of soil over the top of the footing and where the top layer of the soil starts. We will revise this to be 24 inches. Lastly is the definition of the soil layers. Any number of soil layers may be defined with a soil moduli and shear factors specified for each. Here the program is defaulted to 2 layers that total a depth of 144 inches. The program uses these soil layers to automatically generate area springs on both the bottom and sides of the footing. Both the lateral and the vertical springs are compression only. Values for the springs are determined based on the soil moduli. The soil varies over the depth of the footing. The program will use the average value. The soil springs have a value equal to the soil moduli times the tributary area of each joint in the footing mesh. For our model, we are going to assume that the soil moduli varies over the depth and define an additional layer. The first layer will be 36 inches thick, which when accounting for the cover places the bottom of the layer at the middle of our 24 inch thick footing. It will have a moduli of 0.06. We will add a row, and this layer will be only 12 inches thick. This will place the bottom of the layer at the bottom of the footing. It will have a moduli of 0.1. We will leave the last row as is. The layers look something like this. The last area on the form is the model 3D display. Here we see a 3D representation of the footing based on the parameters we have specified. We can alter the colors, and here we will set the footing color to green to make it easier to identify. We have now completed defining the foundation and can proceed to the next step of adding it to our model. First, we will release the column bases where we are going to add the footings. We add the foundation to the model via the Draw menu. All the foundations use this Draw command, except for the Strip foundation. On the Properties of Object form, note that the isolated footing just defined is selected, and then click on the column bases. The isolated footing assemblies are added to our model. Exactly how are these footings modeled in SAP 2000? Let's zoom in to a footing. First, we have the column. Next, we have the isolated footing. The area objects used to model the footing are placed at the mid-depth of the footing, or 12 inches below the bottom of the column. To connect the bottom of the column to the area objects, the program adds a link object with stiff properties to approximate the stiffness of the footing. The program also adds some transfer beams to help distribute the column loads into the footing. If we right-click on any of the items added with the foundation, we can see which foundation assembly it is associated with. In this case, Foundation Assembly 1. If we return to the Define menu, the Foundation Assemblies command allows us to see all the foundation assemblies in our model, in this case 1 and 2. Assemblies are simply a collection of objects used to model a foundation. We can use the Modify button to rotate the footing. Updating the assembly simply means that any changes made to the objects in the foundation assembly after it was drawn will be reset to the values used in the foundation definition. For example, if you assign a different shell section to an area object, updating it will change it back to the property used in the foundation definition. Unlinking the individual objects will leave all the objects in place in the model, but will no longer keep them as an assembly. The assembly will be deleted. Thus, if you unlink an assembly and then go back and modify the foundation definition, the changes in the foundation definition will not be reflected in the unlinked assembly. We can also use this form to select one or more of the assemblies. If we zoom in and then right-click on the link, we can verify that it is indeed 12 inches long. And that relatively large stiffnesses are used to approximate rigid behavior. if we right-click on a corner area object generated to model the footing, we see that the program has given the section a default name of T24, since it is 24 inches thick. It has also assigned it a type of thin shell. If we double-click on T24 and then click the Modify Show button, we see that the shell is indeed 24 inches thick with a type of thin shell. Also note that there are a total of three area springs defined. One on the bottom or vertical support, and one on edge face 1, and one on edge face 2 for lateral resistance. Note that all three are compression only, as previously stated. As for the spring values shown here as 0.08, previously we said that the program would use the average soil moduli over the depth of the footing, which if we look at the soil moduli would be the average of 0.06 and 0.1, which is 0.08 as shown here. Also note that the object is 324 inches square, information we will need in a moment. As a final step, we will run the analysis so that we can take a look at the soil springs generated. We can now see all of the green springs that have been added to the footing. To verify that the correct stiffness is being used for the soil springs, we start by right-clicking on a joint to get a deflection. For joint 24, the deflection is 0.03395 inches. Next, we will take a look at the force on the joint. For joint 24, this is 0.88 kips. Stiffness equals force divided by displacement. So the spring stiffness K equals 0.88 divided by 0.0395, which gives 25.9 kips per inch at the joint. A moment ago, we noted that the surface area was 324 square inches for each of our shell elements. If we use this as a tributary area for this joint, and remembering that the average soil moduli for the footing was 0.08 kips per inch cubed, the spring stiffness at the joint should be 0.08 times 324, which also gives 25.9 kips per inch. This matches and confirms the behavior of the program. This concludes this tutorial on how to quickly add parametrically defined foundation assemblies to SAP 2000 models.